Hi everyone, welcome to WP Pocket. In today's video, I will show you three different ways to add custom code into the Functions.php file. If you prefer written article, then you can find the link of this article in the description below. The first and easiest way to add custom code snippets to your Functions.php file is Code Snippets plugin. So go to your dashboard and go to the plugins and click Add New. Then type Code Snippets in the search bar. Install and activate this plugin. After activating this plugin, you will get Snippets option in the dashboard. Go to the Snippets option and click Add New. Now enter a title for your custom code. This title will help you to identify this code in the future. Then paste your code inside this code field. Then select Run Snippets Everywhere. Selecting this option will run this code everywhere on your website. But if you just want to run this code in the front end, then select Only Run on the site front end. Then scroll down and you can also add description and tag for this code. Then click Save Changes and Activate. After that, this code will start running on your website. You can also go to the All Snippets option. Here you can manage all your codes. You can just click to disable or enable any code. Now the second way to add custom code to your website is child theme. So go to the appearance, then go to the theme editor. If you have not created your child theme yet, then you can visit my website to see how you can create a child theme. Then click on the drop-down menu and select your child theme. Then select functions.php file. Now you can paste your code inside PHP opening and closing tag. This is the PHP opening tag. But there is no PHP closing tag. PHP closing tag will look like this. But there is no PHP closing tag, so you can just add your code at the end. And click Update File. After that, this code will start running on your website. But I don't want to use this code on my website, so I am going to delete it. Now the third and permanent way to add custom code to your website is site-specific plugin. To create a site-specific plugin, go to your desktop, right-click to create a new folder. You can name this folder anything, but I am going to create this plugin for my website, so I will name it WP Pocket. Then open Notepad. Now go to the written article page. You can find the link of this article in the description below. Scroll down to the bottom section. Then copy this code. Now go to the Notepad file and paste this code. You can change plugin name and description as per your requirement. This plugin name and description will be visible on the WordPress dashboard. Then save this file inside the folder which you created on the desktop. Open this folder and save this file with .php extension. Select all files inside Save As Type, then click Save. Now close this file and go to your desktop. As you can see, I saved my file inside the folder. Now right click on this folder and click Send To, then compress this folder into a zip file. Now go to your website go to the plugins and click add new. Click upload plugin. Then click choose file. Now choose the plugin which you just created. Then click install now. Then activate this plugin. As you can see, plugin name and plugin description is visible on the WordPress dashboard. Now go to the plugin editor. Select your site specific plugin. Now you can add your code between these two lines and click update file. After clicking the update file, your code will start running on the website. I hope you found this video helpful. Thanks for watching WP Pocket.